So happened. This is Amit and you are watching my channel Information in Educational Video. As this channel is updating you about in each and everything regarding the BITSAT counseling process. So here is the clarification video. Some of the doubts are there as the first iteration result has been announced. So here I would like to clear some of your doubts. So first thing is I am in waitlisting candidate. So in which branch I am in waitlisting? So nothing. There is no particular branch. You are in waitlisting. Many students have 180 marks. They are in waitlisted candidate. Many students are having 140. So there is no deadline or no cutoff like every branch waitlisting. There is a particular cutoff. So there is no cutoff. Even if you have 120 marks, they will be put you into the waitlisted candidate because they want to have your money so that later if there will be some seat, they will provide you and they will take your money, as simple as that. Now the next question is when I have to pay the fee as I have got the seat now, and if I am in waitlisting, then how I need to pay the fee. So if you are in waitlisted candidate, then you have to pay 51,800, that is up to 6th. And if you have got the seat, then you have to pay the first semester fee, that is up to 6th of July. This is the final thing. If you miss this payment, you will be out of the counseling process. No one can put you again into the counseling process unless there is a spot out of the counseling process. So this is very straightforward. If after paying, that is up to 6th, once you pay and thereafter you think that I have got IIT, I will not join BITSAT. So you can take the withdrawal also from 13th to 15th. You can take the withdrawal option also and you can get the 100% refund of your money, whatever you have paid. Now the important thing is that now I am satisfied with the seat, whatever I have got. If I will get any better in iteration 2/3, it is okay, but I am fine. How I can take the admission, how I should proceed with that. So the important thing is that the physical verification with your all document will be done on 9th of August, whether you got the seat in first iteration, second, third or fourth. So all type of iteration will be done on 9th. Thereafter 5th and 6th iteration, there will be separate physical reporting. So at that time, many type of student will not reach there. Even they have CSE in Pilani, CSE in Goa or CSE in Hyderabad. That's why the cutoff will change a lot after 4 iteration. In 5th and 6th you will see lots of changes because of the physical. But now, as you also know, now they have provided the seat in iteration 1 to many students. There is even 215 marks a student, 220 marks a student have filled everything, that is MSc bio, manufacturing, everything. So they have provided the seat, that's why the cutoff is up now. But in upcoming iteration, as people will be taking the refund and as people will not go for the verification, so it will change and there will be lots of changes. As I'm doing it from 5 years, so I know this thing. Last year also, you can check my video, every iteration I provided the update and there was exact match whatever I provided, because I am guiding lots of students where I stay with my guidance. So now the important thing is that I would like to inform you about my guidance. If you want, you can contact me so that I will guide you for the best possible branch in BITS, that is in best campus, best branch. And also the important thing, you need to go with BITS colleges or with other colleges. Everything I will be discussing with you so that you will able to take the right decision, because many of you are having the expectation to go foreign country for higher education. Many student wants to get the higher salary, so it depends on your decision making also, that is what type of future you want. So all depends on your decision making now. So in that I will be helping you. If you want, you can contact me through Instagram or WhatsApp number. There is a nominal charge for that. Next question is, I am waitlisted candidate. If I will pay, then if there will be no seat allotment up to the 6th iteration or 7th, 8th, whatever will happen this year, so what will happen with my fee? You will get the refund automatically. No need to worry. Even after paying the waitlisting fee and next iteration you will get some seat, then if you don't want to take that seat, you can do the withdrawal option as well. It is as simple as that. And the important thing is that now in first iteration, as you also know, those students who we are having 300 marks or 250, 280, 290, all those students have put, maximum students have put 38 choices. So that's why the lower branch is also having high cutoff, that is 180 marks students haven't got anything. But in a last iteration, even 150 marks, 145 marks students will get the seat. So no need to worry. Very soon I am going to provide the updated cutoff, that is for up to the last round. And please try to comment down what you have got, what your marks, so that other people can take the reference, and I will also take the reference from that. So it's my request. Please try to comment down whatever you got and what is your marks. Thank you.